name is Dr. Kobe Mentor. I teach tourism marketing and many other marketing programs. Now this particular event, which is the Destination Marketing Exhibition, is a practical part of the tourism marketing course where students get the chance to experience or actually try their hands on most of the tourism theories that we've actually taught in class. Now it is meant to build their capacity so that when they come out of school and they're actually given a destination to market, it makes it easier for them. And students must understand that selling a destination is entirely just like you're selling a product or services. And as a result, they need to have the experience, the expertise in doing that. So I think essentially this is how we try to, you know, let a student have a hands-on experience on marketing destinations, and that's what you see today.
Today's exhibition is our project work, and we are supposed to develop strategies that would influence repeat purchase of tourist sites in Ghana. So for my group, we chose Ebui, and the name of the group is Visit Ebui. So we have a number of products here based on the piece. So we have products, we have place, we have price, we have promotion, and then we have the relationship.
We are exhibiting Labadi, Destination Labadi, the land of leisure. The unique thing about Labadi is the beach and, you know, what nature has to offer.
When you go to the beach, like as you can see here, some say they go for romance, some say they come for the beauty, some say they go for the memories, some go for the swim, and then some go especially for the fun.
We are trying to sell Ghana through the foods we have in the country. We want Ghanaians themselves to be able to experience and try the foods from various regions, the fruits from various regions, the nuts, the fast food, baked food, steamed food that we've never experienced, although we are living in Ghana or call ourselves Ghanaians, so that we can share with others who come from other countries how tasty Ghana is.
We are the Airport City Group, and we decided to choose Airport City because we believe that this is the modern Ghana, this is the new Ghana, and this is where the new tourists, the up-and-coming youth, would want to visit Ghana. It's not all about coming to Ghana to visit Akosombo and other places. Sometimes you have to visit the city, just like people go to New York to visit the city and London.
So Team Akosombo is all about reselling Akosombo to someone that has already been there. We started off as just a school project to help promote some of the hotels in Akosombo and to help people re-go back there. So we came up with ideas of reducing the price, strategies and promotion plans to help have packages to convey people from one place to the other.
Akosombo, we realize, has a lot of historical facts and sceneries, like the Adome Bridge, the Akosombo Dam that was constructed and supervised by the first president, Osagyefo Dr. Kwame Nkrumah.
Today I present to you Team Think Ghana, Think Coco. Our target market are foreigners and locals interested in agricultural tourism, as well as business groups or individuals interested in investing in the farm and sector of Ghana.
I like your theme, Think Ghana, Think Coco. I mean, if you look at the significance of Coco and your theme, it's on point. Well done. The issue about the venue has great historical history. We never mentioned about it.
What I've experienced today is magical, it's amazing, it's interesting. The lecturers and the whole school is not just teaching young people theories, but letting them go out there to go and experience it, design it, and strategize, and put it in a presentation against a group of critical thinkers for analysis.
Destination Legon is a very interesting concept because I believe in experiential learning where people experience, put to practice what they learn.
I'd like to commend the university. I would like to also commend the faculty and the department for this insightful presentation.
Well, this is not my first time of coming to Destination Legon. I have been coming here for quite almost every year since they started it.
Being a part of Destination Lagos 2016 has been an awesome experience for me. I like the work the various teams have put together.
It is very revealing and refreshing that students from both undergrad and master's level can undertake such projects and delve into even product innovations, recommendations, and what have you.
Usually when you look at museum, you look at a serene, quiet, and pensive place, usually. But we are trying to say that you could create it to become fun.
We're representing Team Golden Moments, and our theme is the Western 360.
This year, our strategy is to promote repeat purchase amongst tourists in Ghana. And our destination we chose is Labadi, hence our name, Destination Labadi.
Our model of business is to use intense encouragement for donations. But the Lord will allow you to earn direct revenue by collecting money. So, to be smart about it as business people, we are going to use the internet, which transcends the borders of the university, and create what is called a pay-per-view.
So with our packages, we have the 4-star, 3-star, 2-star, and the 1-star. Our biggest package, the 4-star, is called the Manche package.
We at Tour Jamestown, we believe that the potential the community has needs to be shown to the entire world so that we can attract many more tourists coming to the place.
Yeah, because it is amazing, even though its character is like this, even now you can actually pay money to go and see it. Because I believe that your strategy seeks to sell Jamestown now.
Each year brings different dimensions to it. And I think this is a very, 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 very good program.
I think that this is the way to go.
I think it's a step in the right direction, and it has to be repeated down the line.
It allows the students to blend theory with practice, and this is what is needed out there.
We shouldn't worry about problems we have in our society. If they can turn lemons to lemonades, then it means that we have a way to go.
You cannot just go and talk about theory without practice. So the students need to be given a platform, an opportunity to practicalize what they learn in the classroom. And I think that is exactly what this particular program is doing.
Thumbs up to the lecturers that, you know, they have impacted so much knowledge to them.
A lot of money can be made out of these things if they decide to go the full distance.
I do hope and pray that the students will look at it beyond just acquiring the marks and passing the exams, but look at it within the context that, listen, this is very practical, this is equipping them with so many transferable skills that is priceless out there. And I do also hope that the school itself recognizes that this is the way to go and provides sufficient resources to the school to continue to expand it.
It's a learning process. Some have made some mistakes, but they are correctable mistakes.
I am in total awe at the level of knowledge that these students have poured on me today, and I'm grateful to be a part of it.
Coming from GIJ, we certainly would want to see more collaboration between us and the business school to continue to push for this blend of theory and practice.
Congratulations, University of Ghana, Lagos.
You've done very well. Tears for others. You share.